Today, I'm extremely angry. Angry because there is a company called Reflect Orbital. They're working on a very new system of artificial satellites that will hoist mirrors and reflect sunlight at Earth at night. This may sound like an awesome feat of engineering, but in this video, I'll explain why it's extremely bad, unnatural, and probably just another science scam. Hey beautiful people, you're watching PhysxX. Let's start understanding what this company actually wants at first. Reflect Orbital is a California-based startup founded in 2021 by Ben Nowak and Tristan Semelak, aiming to revolutionize renewable energy production by utilizing space-based technology. The company focuses on deploying a constellation of satellites equipped with reflective mirrors to redirect sunlight onto solar power plants after dark, effectively allowing solar energy generation to continue even when the sun is not shining. Reflect Orbital's primary objective is to address the intermittent nature of solar energy generation. Solar farms typically generate power only during daylight hours, which can lead to energy shortages during peak demands, especially at night. As for the matter of fact, households or residential areas need a huge power surge after working hours for obvious reasons, but industrial areas' demand falls rapidly after working hours. By reflecting sunlight to solar panels after sunset, the company aims to provide a continuous supply of solar power, thereby maximizing the efficiency and productivity of solar energy systems. The proposed system could add approximately 30 minutes of sunlight to solar farms during critical energy demand periods, enhancing their output significantly. The company plans to launch a constellation of 57 small satellites, each weighing around 35 pounds, 16 kilograms, into a sun-synchronous polar orbit at an altitude of 370 miles or 600 kilometers. Each satellite will be equipped with a large mylar mirror measuring 33 feet by 33 feet, designed to concentrate and direct sunlight into specific areas on Earth. This innovative approach aims to sell sunlight on demand, allowing solar farms to generate energy even at night. Testing and development. Reflect Orbital has already conducted successful preliminary tests, of course, according to them. In a notable experiment, the company used a hot air balloon to carry a mylar mirror and reflect sunlight into a mobile solar farm. This test demonstrated that the technology could generate approximately 500 watts of energy per square meter of solar panel, which is about half of the brightness of direct sunlight. The company is set to launch its first prototype satellite into orbit in 2025, with applications for their sunlight service already attaching significant interest. Now, let's discuss a little history of the company, just so you can get a better idea why I don't like this at all. Reflect Orbital was founded in 2021, emerging from a vision to harness the untapped potential of solar energy beyond daylight hours. The project of using space-based reflectors is not entirely new. Previous projects, such as Russia's Zanmia project, in the 1990s attempted similar concept but faced significant technical challenges. Reflect Orbital aims to build on this past efforts of modern technology and a clear focus on practical applications. So we have kind of failed ones with this kind of projects. Though the founders themselves are not so bad, probably. Ben Nowak serves as the CEO of Reflect Orbital. Ben Nowak, a 26-year-old inventor and entrepreneur, holds degree in interdisciplinary and mechanical engineering from Wentworth Institute of Technology. He has a diverse background, including building a fission reactor in high school and working at SpaceX as an unpaid intern on the Dragon 2 capsule. In 2021, he founded Reflect Orbital. Tristan Semelhack, the co-founder and CTO, plays a crucial role in the technical development of satellites and mirrors. Together, Nowak and Semelhack lead a small team dedicated to refining their technology and preparing for upcoming satellite launches. While Reflect Orbital's vision is ambitious, it's not without challenges. Concerns have been raised regarding the potential for light pollution and the impact on astronomical observations. Experts warn that if not designed carefully, these orbiting mirrors could outshine celestial bodies, exacerbating existence issues with satellite light pollution. Though Reflect Orbital has committed to minimizing the efforts, stating that the mirrors will be designed to ensure they do not interfere with astronomical observations. Here is where my problem begins. You know, with money, people try to do everything. I'm a great supporter of most kind of space explorations and space technology developments, but only those that do not harm humanity. This isn't one of those. Have you ever been blinded by a car's headlight on your rearview mirror at night? Just think, if there's something that keeps on happening to you while you're trying to enjoy the darkness, or maybe watching the sky using a telescope, or maybe just sleeping. This is outrageous. Though I understand that it's an awesome piece of engineering and extremely difficult to make it happen, but some things are better untouched. If you disagree, then leave a comment. If not, then show some support, please. Selling things that we already get for free from nature by hurting the nature has become such an overwhelming business opportunity for some opportunist businessmen. Let it be water, oxygen, or anything else. Now, sunlight? Seriously? Is this the future that you want? Now, let's talk about this project's viability and some economics. The feasibility and economic viability of launching and maintaining a constellation of satellites remain to be fully assessed. The company has secured funding from investors such as Climate Capital and Starship Ventures, which will be crucial in supporting their development and launch efforts. We already know that it's a huge capital intensive business, and every day a company goes bankrupt in this space. Even SpaceX was once on the verge of bankruptcy, but they were saved by NASA. But this isn't something that NASA will ever invest on, at least for the next 100 years. We seriously have better ways to find sources of renewable energy without hurting the nature. As you know, there contains a massive number of asteroids in the asteroid belt, with estimates ranging from 1.1 to 1.9 million asteroids larger than 1 kilometer in diameter and millions of smaller ones. The reflected sunlight from this company's mirror in the low Earth orbit could disrupt the operations of ground-based telescopes used for asteroid detection and monitoring. The additional light in the night sky may make it harder to detect and identify asteroids, especially smaller ones, against the brighter background. Just think, we were hit by an asteroid that we missed because we were busy making some money by selling sunlight. Would that be fun? Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more real science content. Thank you.